Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Hollowtide back again, once again. I'm in a brand new room. I don't know what the mic quality is going to sound like. It might be super, like, echoey. So I apologize if it does. Maybe I won't even upload this. Who knows? But there has been a lot of news about Halo Infinite since I have been gone, moving, whatever. And that includes the no Forge at launch and no co-op campaign at launch, as well as the release date, which, so there's a lot to talk about. I'm just going to give my opinions, my thoughts on them real quick, even though it's like kind of old news at this point. I figured I might as well make a video and whatnot and discuss it. So no Forge at launch does suck, but I think I understand why. It's going to be a massive undertaking. This Forge is going to basically be like a game development engine at this point. And I'm super excited to see what people come up with. I think that staggering the release might be an okay thing this time around, as opposed to Halo 5. But it does stink that there won't be custom modes and things like that at launch. And, you know, it could be 6 months or longer before we get a Forge mode. So that's unfortunate. And I do wish that the game was shipping complete. But honestly, I kind of do hope that they're focusing more on making sure that what is going to release is fantastic. As for the no co-op campaign, I am actually really disappointed in that. I did want to play campaign with friends. I think there's going to be a lot of replayability in campaign, and I think that I'll play it definitely through one time, my first time, by myself, and then I might wait or, you know, play here and there, do new things, fun times on stream and whatnot in the campaign, but really wait for my friends to do it 100% again, because I do have a lot of fun playing co-op campaign with people. I think that that's a lot of fun. One of the things that Destiny, I think, does actually well is the PvE side, where you're able to do these missions and things with people. And I think that that is important for Halo going forward. So I'm actually really upset about no co-op campaign. The other thing that we got was the release date of December 8th, and I am surprised that it's not November 15th. I really think that that was a prime opportunity with it being the anniversary of CE and Halo's anniversary overall. I would have loved to have seen it released then. I think that a lot of people are worried that 343 is literally waiting to the last minute, or Microsoft is waiting to the last minute to release it, but I don't know how big of a difference 3 weeks, or yeah, barely 3 weeks, weeks would make in a release. Maybe it is a huge difference. I don't know. I'm not a game dev. I'm disappointed that it's not coming out sooner, obviously, because we've been waiting a year since the delay. So it stinks. It sucks, but it's whatever, I guess. What's another couple weeks at this point? As long as the game is polished, is fun, and is a quality experience, then I will be happy. They did come out with an Inside Infinite update, and they talk about the flight and a lot about the bots, but there has been no new news about the BTB flight, so that kind of sucks. I wish that we had more info. I also saw the Gamescom trailer for the multiplayer season 1-0, season whatever, with Lorette, and I actually really like that. I do think that it kind of is weird because you see like Big Ben and lore stuff and the Spartans that come out, and then Lorette's age, and there's a lot of question marks that I don't know what's going to happen lore-wise, story-wise, and how they plan to explain all that. But I will say that New London, whatever this is, looks phenomenal. I hope we get to see more places like this because it is fantastic. I get super hardcore ODST vibes. But like these futuristic cities mixed in with the old relics of the past, I love that. I hope we get to see more and more of that. I would love to see like Chicago or Seattle, or I don't know, just this huge metropolis futuristic city. I think is super cool. It gives me hardcore, very clean Blade Runner vibes, like if the Blade Runner world wasn't so gross. So I love that. But let me hear your opinions down in the comments down below. If you guys want to help me out, make sure you like the video. If you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, and I will catch you in the next one. Peace.